Hey guys, it's Sasuke here, and welcome back to The Binding of Issac Afterbirth. So today, I read up online about the greed mode thing. Apparently, certain characters, like, the amount that you donate sticks with each character, I think is what I read online. So, like, Issac has, like, a 17% chance to break or something, and, like, that's always going to be an Issac. The other characters should have a lower percent chance of breaking. So, if I had to guess, one of the lower people that we probably haven't played too much is probably Eve, if I had to, you know, give an educated guess. So let's play her in greed mode. Because, you know, Eve isn't my favorite character. I don't play her a lot anyway. Stem cells is fine. We're probably going to hurt ourselves and bring ourselves down to the Horror Babylon state. And I believe that this is going to make the razor blades actually going to be really good for her too. So that's convenient. Allows us to get in here for free. Huh, let me get this for free. Nice. So, first we do this, then we go 1, 2, there we go. Now we're in Horror Babylon state, so we have increased damage. We also keep increased damage, I believe, for this entire room. Because it gives you, no, that was just like dumb play. But it gives you damage for the room that you're on. And it also activates our dead bird, which is going to be nice for us too. So we have good damage. We have low HP, but we should be able to survive as long as we don't go too full retard. And I have good plans for this run, needless to say. Because I played Nuclear Throne before this, and Nuclear Throne went really well. We had a pretty damn good run. Wasn't like godlike or anything, but by no means was it bad. And I think that bodes well for our chances in Issac today. Because normally, the two are connected. When I do well in Nuclear Throne, I do really well in Issac. And it's just, I don't know, it's been that way for a couple months, maybe. Like, ever since Afterbirth came out, it's kind of been that way. And when I do poorly in Nuclear Throne, I also do poorly in Issac. So maybe it's just every day has a different set of skills or something. I think we should probably just go ahead and fight the bosses. Because we have that damage bonus right now from the, when they break, they pop out a single pop shot, by the way, so you need to be careful for that. So, know your positioning when you break them. That's all I can tell. Double? Wow, double break. But yeah, I figure we may as well go ahead and finish this up while we have the damage bonus from the razor blade. Oh, that was real scary. I believe these guys would one-shot us, too, because they're technically champions. Maybe I'm wrong about that. Nicely done. Might as well go ahead and do the deal with the double too. Like, we have our full damage maximum right now, and leaving at all would just lose this damage. So. We got the Headless Horseman, so that will one-shot us. The bomb will. Pretty sure just a normal shot from the guy won't. Just stay out of the range of that. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You weren't supposed to come from the right side. Romeo. Now he should have come from the left, right? Now he went up. Damn it. Okay, he's down. Go check our deal the double. We have 3 hearts to spend. Looks like we don't get to spend any. Come on. No troll bomb. Double. Luck up is great. Let's wait till we're in here to use them. Speed up. Speed it's fine. Up. We don't really want any of this, but we do need this. I will take the heart too. Because we can always hurt ourselves to get out of to get into Horror Babylon. Use a shadow. We're going to take it just in case we do die, but I kind of don't want to be Judas because I think we've done Judas the Shadow a lot, and that is going to have a low percent chance of good stuff happening for us. So BFFs is pretty tempting. We'll go ahead and take it. I like it enough. Plus, it'll make our bros a lot bigger too. Like when we hurt ourselves, our bird should be bigger. Should just be all around good. Dude, stiff. Really don't want caffeine pill. I mean, I'll take it if we have to, but I'd like love to reroll, and there is a D6, so we're probably gonna be doing that. D6 love. Well, I don't think D6 is like the best item in the game. I do think it's just like, it's so solid. It's one of those items that you'd almost never be angry to get, right? Wow, that is like the same room twice. Strangely enough. Let's go ahead and do the key. Loki horns, it's not great. But I do think it's interesting. And, you know, I mean, it could make something really cool happen for us. So, one, two, there we go. For Babylon again, we have the extra damage bonus as we did last floor. We also have a bigger, dead bird. So maybe we'll be able to get something out of that. It's, kind of the hope and dream anyway, is that dead bird is useful. No. Oh, that was unfortunate. I hate those random shots that pop out, man. They get me every time. These guys can one-shot us because they shoot those bombs, and those bombs are one-hits. Oh, itchy face. Itchy face when the bats come. Where you gonna be when the bats come? Bat boys, bat boys. What you gonna do? What you gonna do when the bats come for you? We just need to mine their jumps, and they're dead. Dead bird is, like, really putting in some work, I'll be honest. That was scary. Oh, we were gonna get hit by that, to be 100% honest. Still scary to do this, but Polycephalus, oh no, is a boss that could easily hit us. I'll take care of these guys because they're the most annoying. As long as Dead Bird gets in there and does some work for us, I think we're gonna be fine. Oh, that was bad. So we're down to our last breath here. Dead Bird did do his job. We don't know where that other guy is though, and that scares me. Getting a little bit of frame lag. Why that is. Oh, on the right scene. This is another guy that could easily hit us. I really want Dead Bird to like get in there. There you go. Stay on him, Dead Bird. Don't let him out of your sight. Dead Bird doing his job again. Do a little bit of a jump. Oh, Dead Bird aggroed. In there, Dead Bird. But we only have half a heart, so anything can kill us, which scares the crap out of me. Which is why I'm staying so far back, by the way. Don't want to risk it for the biscuit. So normally we would do the deal of the devil here. I'm scared, man. Way too scared. First, we're going to buy this. And we're going to go grill this. Scent oil is way better. Don't have any luck upgrades. Buy this for safety. I know we're gonna have a lot lower damage now. But I think living is probably gonna be better than, you know, having an E-penis of damage. I'm pretty sure we can do this fight. It's just gonna take a... This is one I could see me conceivably getting hit on too, so rather happy we did take the HP. I don't think it would have, like... I think the chances of getting hit on this fight, especially with higher damage, is pretty low. But it does happen, because there are troll bombs that he does throw. I mean the mega troll bombs that actually chase you. Those are the dangerous ones. Oh, see? There went the hit. We would have got deadened there. So the extra hit is going to be real nice for us. Man, he is really annoying on these big rooms. You always fight him on, like, normal-sized rooms, so when you fight him on these big rooms, you just never expect how tedious it is to follow this guy around. Extra speed does help out quite a bit in that endeavor, though. Alright, let's hope we can trade some of this HP away. Black hearts are actually really good. Because that means we can keep our D6, because I was about to say we probably need to go back to that, but actually keep our D6 with this setup. Not super excited because we don't feel very strong right now. We don't feel weak with the Horde of Babylon going, but we just gotta make sure not to accidentally pick up a red heart. Speedball. Speed and range, I believe. Which isn't terrible. Really is a bomb. Two bombs, actually. So let's risk it for the biscuit. We literally did nothing. I'd really love a bomb item. Chad, that gives kisses. I don't think we want it because we're trying not to get red hearts right now. If anything, we're gonna want to try to trade away these red hearts so we can get a nice deal with the devil and not have to worry about losing our permanent Polaroid. Or not permanent Polaroid. Jesus Christ, I'm on like one Issac mined right now. Our damage bonus from Horror Babylon, that's what I'm trying to think. I can't even think. It's not working. Oh, I don't, if you guys are one of the very few that actually follow like all my work, and you guys have seen the episode where I had to go mid-episode, and you're wondering like what was the package that came in, it was my my girlfriend's present. I bought her a present for Christmas. It finally came in. She's super excited about it. But she's at work right now, so she's like kinda have to wait. I mean, I'm happy Dead Bird finally gets to show up, especially because like we chose BFF just to help the Dead Bird deal more damage. Same point in time, it does suck that we got hit. But I mean, we do have the black heart, right? So if things do go really, really wrong, which they tend to when I play, we have that little bit of insurance, at least. Oh, I did not see you. Oh, hit him! Okay, is this the last guy? Not you. This asshole. We're gonna go ahead and keep fighting because we have the dead bird. Probably not my wisest choice. That was real scary, to be honest. I only mostly pooped my pants there. So here's this fast shot speed shots. The only thing you need to know about the slow shot speed shots is that you need to take them by moving like slow, and these you just need to watch your timing faster. Sounds kind of strange, but I swear it's really easy. I think he's confused because we're so close to him. Need you to die? This was not a part of the arrangement? Oh my god. Dog! Thank you. Thanks for killing him, by the way. I mean, I know we didn't really get off on the right foot, but I really highly appreciate what you're doing for this country. Except for that shit, you can just fuck off forever. Oh, I keep falling for it. I don't know why. I always fall for the fucking four-way brimstone. Holy light. See, that time he didn't do it. If I would have fucking... Oh my god. I get so mad at myself sometimes. Okay. Little Chad will reroll. Let's take this. Come on, go, baby. I mean, we have BFF. I hate losing. I really hate losing. Yeah. Poor Babylon. But I'm scared. Rightfully so, I think. I think it's kind of nice to be able to find the secret rooms. They generally have enough money to pay this off. And sometimes they have bombs. Sometimes they have really... Like this. This actually saves us a whole lot of trouble. Because now we know that we just don't even need to fight this. So that actually saves us so much trouble. Do we want any of this here? We could store extra room. I think it's still glitched, though. It doesn't work for the D6 properly. Range? I'm so sad that we're leaving so many good things behind. But, you know, there's not too much we can do about it. We'll GTFO, go on to the next floor, hopefully find something worth it. Because, oh, baby. You had me at hello, Magic Mush. You didn't have to say anything else. I always buy these, and for that reason. Two of diamonds is gonna propel us out of control, hopefully. Anything else here? We could lower our damage for a massive tiers upgrade. We'll see. Collar is fine. That sucks to take the damage, but it's not really too much of a problem. Not very good. We haven't checked the shops. Let's buy this. Everyone's gonna lower our range quite a bit, but we have a couple range upgrades, yeah. It's perfectly fine. So now we don't need that at all. See what we can get for 3 cents. Dolly. I like Dolly. That's like exactly what I was hoping for. I should have lost all my red hearts before I did that. That was kind of stupid. Oh well. But we won't get to, our damage isn't like incredible. But our damage is probably where it was when we had permanent bullet, or not. God, I keep saying it. When we had Horror Babylon initially, if I had to guess. Yeah, I'm happy we went ahead and got that out of the way. so we didn't have to deal with that annoyance of those guys, because if you accidentally shoot them, they just let out a million shots. I'm loving the run right now, though. We're doing pretty damn good. We aren't, like, going crazy, but we're definitely strong. Can't remember if you can actually run through the little... I think that's an umbilical cord between those two. Ah, oh, there's a brain leaving creep everywhere. Bad. Alright, we got the chasers out of the way. We just need to kill that brain. We need to kill the big guy, so he'll leave us alone. Then we need to focus on staying around the outside and killing most of these poppers, I think. Probably a good choice. Because we don't want to get too far on the inside, because that's where the brains are primarily going to be, right? Okay, almost all poppers are dead. And brains are dead. We're good. We live. See you another day. Another reroll here. We picked up both of these, yeah. So, we'll keep our reroll for the Duel of the Devil. Might just go ahead and double our money this floor, because we might want to buy something. That's my thought process. Man, I wish we had bombs this round, though. I feel like we could have got so much more done with bombs. These two tiers upgrades between Mr. Dolly and, I think Mr. Dolly may not be a tier. Maybe. Oh, there's three? Oh, we're gonna take damage here, boys. Without a doubt, there's damage being had tonight. We use this as cover, like CSGO style. Just don't panic. Okay, one's dead at least. I pretty much knew I was gonna take damage here. This is an extremely hard room without flight. With flight, this room would be like an instant KO without even thinking about it. Okay, so we still have a reroll. Let's go ahead. Really fighting. Wow, Quadrophalocephalus plus Monstro 2? What the frick, Batman? Well, these guys have no HP. Never mind. These guys, I thought this was gonna be worse than this, but they have enough HP to equal like one monster. Probably Monstro 2 doesn't have too much either. Oh my god. Oh, he spawned on top of us. That angers me. I hate when things spawn on top of you. Like, one of my pet peeves in this game. Because they fixed it with a lot of stuff. Like, they fixed it with those poppers I was talking about in the last wave. They haven't fixed it with the Polycephalus, and it's real annoying. Biggest piss off in A. Wish we had a bomb. Maybe we do take this, though. We have BFF. It's not bad. Go ahead and do this. Spades. Two keys is nice. It'll save us some money. Go ahead and reroll. A luck upgrade. Jesus juice is definitely worth it. We're still looking for stuff still. 7 cent for an orbital is completely, in my opinion, worth it. How much use could we get out of these bombs is the question. I'm gonna buy it because it gives us the black heart. Gave us one bomb. That's not what I was hoping for. Definitely not what I was hoping for. That's fine, though. Could have been a lot worse. Go ahead and head down. We have Shoal, and then we have the other room still, so we can just save up our money between those two rooms. We should be good, I think. We have our free key for here, so that's pretty good. Nightlight isn't bad, but is it, like, worth actually grabbing? Maybe. Placenta is also not bad. But is that worth grabbing, too? It could infinitely ruin our chances of ever getting ourselves down to the Whore of Babylon state, pretty much. Is not my favorite thing. Two more keys, we're like not in need of keys. Pretty fly is great. Bad gas is like not terrible, and luck upgrade is great too. So we'll keep our other bad gas pill, I suppose. Or, you know, whatever we may be able to use. I wish we had gotten more bombs now. Yeah. I think we're gonna take Nightlight, because just think, we aren't gonna be able to reroll everything here. I think we'll take Nightlight just because Shoal is tedious with the darkness. And, I mean, it's not really going to help us too much with that, but what I'm thinking is, like, why reroll a single room with a decent item when you can reroll a room that has a chance to have two different items to choose from, you know what I mean? That's my thought process, anyway. May not be the most sound thought process, but that's what I'm thinking. Plus, I mean, you never know how useful this is gonna be, right? Damn it. Need to kill these skulls. Okay, there's like three. Mine right here. These guys are kinda hard to hit, they're real tricksy. I don't know how our double died, but he is dead. Shit. I think VFF is helping quite a bit here. It's, I mean, we have decent damage, but it's like an extra little supplement. It's not blowing, like, the waters off this run or anything, but, you know, it's not bad. It's like the free damage. It just comes out of nowhere. Especially with all the orbital chances we've got, I see no reason in not, you know, taking him. Damage upgrade with, meat. It's fine. Gain damage. Only like 0.3, but you know, not bad. Both of these are something that I don't really want. I guess we're gonna save our money. So we don't know where all these guys are for now. Three. There's one more still, so we're gonna do a little run around. Until he shows his face. He should be open to business. I guess he's dead. The dark version of this guy. Don't know what he does. I guess he just does the homing shots. And it looks like the mask is a bit more protective than he usually is. Normally he goes off and kind of does his own thing. Like he's being a bit more protective of his young. By young, I mean his heart. But you know, always keep your heart safe. That's all I gotta tell you, boys. Oh my god, I thought you were done. Scary. Double Krampus. Oh, that was bad. I'm ready for the double cramp. Oh, that was so bad. I'm getting effed up by these brimstones right now. I'm like running from one brimstone and running into the other. That is great. I should have took all my health again with bombs, but we don't have any, so never mind. I'm not as much of an idiot as I was about to feel like I was. Could be better, could be worse. I'm pretty unhappy that there's nothing useful in here, really, and I don't want to waste our money gambling that another one will pop up after we buy one. So, that's that. We're in the shop, we get to see our secret room at least. Two more spirit hearts is fine by me. We also have that golden heart for some extra goodies. Could buy chaos, it's a little late though, to be honest with you.
I can see.
So I think if we do this, it's gonna be, the coins are gonna be in there. Yep, so we had to walk back in. That's unfortunate. Take a bit more damage than I was hoping to, but I think those coins were definitely worth it. Jar of Flies is really good. Growth Hormones is probably what we want. Speed is good. We also got Spun, which gives us more damage. I think Spun is like a 3 damage upgrade or something. It's pretty good. Pretty much what I was, hoping for there. This is the spawn, not the damage. Oh my god, fuck off, you damn ghost, dude. This is ugly. Not what I wanted to have happen. We're getting some pretty good stuff going for us, though, to be honest. We just need to kill these flies before they get to us. Bomb flies. These guys are almost dead. Got them all. There's double greed and a greed head. We should be able to outrange the greeds, so our dodges are much more simple. I almost didn't dodge there. I don't know why. It's just something in my brain said, dude, don't worry about it. You're Neo. They can't hit you. You've seen The Matrix. You've had a blue screen before. All right, here's those annoying-ass hands. I hate these things. Yeah, there's always two. Three. And it's hard as frick to dodge that stuff. I hate it. Ah, the homing shots. So we don't have very much HP, which scares me going into greed. Ow, itchy head. Brick on a stick, Batman. I'm like kinda scared here. Pretty sure greeds need to die first. The harder of the enemies, because they're gonna be throwing out shots while we're doing it. Thank you, Nightlight. I know I totally disrespected you earlier, and I'm pretty sorry about it. I feel like a dick. As long as we can get her to charge repeatedly, and now she's in her sideways phase. Just knock her back and forth and hit her in the butt. Don't take my relationship advice. I don't know what's up there, but it's dead. There's a lot of zombies. So zombies are a little hard sometimes because it'll look like they're running, but it'll actually just be because they're slowed. This is like my least favorite duel, the devil to fight. That's precisely it. As long as you get good positioning on these two, it's usually not too bad. Where I thought they would be. Go ahead and bad guess that guy. We just want to play around this thing, pretty much. And we'd rather have him make the mistakes than us make the mistakes of getting hit. So. There we go. Just fine. Last angel is more protection. And a whole lot of money. I don't know where this money came from. It didn't give us the heart, it just gave us the money for it. Strange, but awesome. So, do we really think we're going to be able to donate 70 cents? Probably not. Oh my god, I hit F. So, say let's like try one reroll and a buy. So we'll try this until it rerolls. Nothing we want, reroll. Nothing we want. One more. Box soy milk. Our tiers are like good already. We don't need that. I really want more. One more item. Box of friends. I mean, D6 is 100% useless, so at least the box of friends will give us something that's functionally useful. 50 cents is more than enough for me. If we donate that amount, I'd be happy. No complaints from me. And plus, you never know, we might get money from the fight as long as we live. Hey, where's the monster, though? We need HP this time. And I'll take your quarter. Don't get me wrong. So, with the extra bros, maybe we'll have some better luck here. I'm not too worried, as long as we play it cool. The main thing is we need to, like, really get most of these dead. I think we got all of them. No, we missed one. Oh, that was bad damage, trying to kill all these. But he got multiples of those because he kinda, he laid it out well for himself, I'll admit. He played me like a fiddle. One door is gonna open, there's nothing we can do about that. Is this one behind? Wow, he's doing lots of HP for himself. That's unfortunate. So he's pretty damn enraged early in this fight, which does, like, frighten me. And we aren't killing these things, like, fast enough. Oh, we got all of them but one. Or did we actually get all of them? Oh, damn. One thing that's gonna be kinda nice, not gonna be, like, game-changing, I don't think. But, we will... Oh my god, that freaking nightlight save, though. Whenever we actually get the chance to deal damage to him, we're hurting real bad. But we're having a hard time getting the damage through just because he has so much crap he's doing. Normally he seems a bit more tame than he is today. He's going a little buck wild on us, a little buck nasty. Buck nasty! We got four of them dead. I'll leave the last one alive. It's too risky to try to regain map control on him when he has this much control. Because he's so enraged right now, you know. He's not full enraged, though, because when he's full enraged, his stomps are nearly instantaneous. It's like, pop, 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 pop. That's real good for us. He did enrage a little bit more from the money he found. So, we do have to, like, fight for map control for this. We got all but one. I'll take it. Or did we actually get them all? I thought we missed one. This is a really bad one, because he has, like, the map control real hard down here. Oh, he got three open. Okay, we just need to handle it real quick. Let's hide in the corner. There we go. Easy peasy lemon squeeze. He actually killed his own friends by doing that, surprisingly. He's being real generous with these coins not landing on our head, too, because that's one thing that can happen in the greed fight, is he'll just freaking spawn a coin straight on your dome, man. Oh my god. These orbitals, though, with the BFF, they're winning it right now. Without them, it'd be game over, man. It's game over. We need to retake map control before he does whatever he's going to do here. He did the coin drop. It's fine. Dead Bird is just putting in work. Putting in overtime. Getting those hours in. This is good for us. We're almost done here. A little dumb of me. There we go. I'm hoping this isn't close to broken. I don't think it is. I don't remember putting a lot in. Yeah, 0%. So it is right. Your percentages of the machine breaking are based per character. So that's really good to know. So we're just gonna sit here. So how you guys doing? Hope it's going well. I'm just looking at my phone because this is so damn boring. I'm just sitting here texting. Oh my god, what? Mm-mm. No, no. Oh, hell no. How you gonna break at 0%? Video games, man. What? I have 50 more cents. We only got 20 in? No, we got 30. We had 80 because he dropped a bunch of bombs. Well, I believe that's going to do today's video, guys. If you guys liked, hit that like button. It lets me know you're enjoying the series and all the good stuff. If you guys did enjoy it, please consider leaving a comment. I read and respond to every single one. It helps the video get to a wider audience and all that good stuff as well. If you guys are enjoying it, consider subscribing to the channel if you aren't already. If you are subscribed, recommend it to anybody who may be interested. Friends, family, coworkers, anybody that likes Issac, Darkest Dungeon, XCOM, shooter games eventually. Just, you know, whatever they may fancy. And anyway, hope you guys have the most amazing day in the whole damn world. Let's see this outro, shall we? Alright, that's enough. See you guys.